I've been asking my mom and dad my whole life if I could have one, but they always said that I was too young. Finally, when I became 10 years old, they said that I could have a puppy, if I saved half of the money myself to buy him. I took every job I could find that summer, running errands for people, collecting newspapers and bottles. I was so excited, I worked harder than I ever have. I never thought that taking care of an animal would be work too. I learned that from my friends, Mr. Flynn and Princess. Princess was Mr. Flynn's guide dog. They lived across the street from my house. For not being able to see, Mr. Flynn sure did a lot of things and went a lot of places. Princess was always with him, protecting him and guiding him.
Hi, Mr. Flynn!
Hi, Amy!
My father was helping me find jobs. One day, he told me about a special job for Mr. Flynn.
I just talked to Mr. Flynn and we might have a summer job for you. See, Mr. Flynn is going to go into the hospital and he's going to need someone to look after Princess for him.
Is Mr. Flynn okay, Dad?
Oh, yeah, he's going to be fine. But he needs somebody responsible to take care of Princess.
Could I do that?
I think so.
See, by putting this harness on Princess, I have a handle to hold on to.
So you can steer her?
No, so she can steer me. When Princess and I are out on the street, she's my eyes.
Is it kind of scary sometimes?
No, I trust Princess. See the clothesline over there?
Yeah?
Well, if I tell Princess to take me to the fence, it would seem like I would run into the clothesline, doesn't it? Now, watch us in action. Princess, forward. Good girl.
Do you ever get tired of taking care of Princess?
No, because Princess never gets tired of taking care of me. I think she's going to miss me when I'm away. Would you spend a lot of time with her, Amy? I don't want her to get too lonely.
You can depend on me, Mr. Flynn. I'll spend a lot of time with her and take good care of her. I promise.
That makes me feel a lot better. She sure is important to me.
Hi, Dad.
Hi. How are things going over here?
Great, Dad. Mr. Flynn's telling me all about Princess.
Amy's promised me that she'll take very good care of her.
I think Amy knows how important a promise is.
Princess and I are going to have a lot of fun together.
Taking care of Princess was real fun at first. She and I would walk all over town together. Mr. Flynn said that guide dogs are taught to understand about 30 commands and are trained to stop when they come to a curb or steps. Guide dogs can't tell red lights from green lights, but they are taught to watch for cars when they come to an intersection. Mr. Flynn said that guide dogs can help blind people lead normal lives again, like having a new pair of eyes. When I would go over to feed Princess, she'd be waiting for me. I never knew that animals get lonely too. Mr. Flynn was right. Animals do depend on us. Taking care of Princess was a lot of work. Mr. Flynn said that animals depend on us, so we should always think about them for ourselves. But that can be real hard. After a while, I got tired of taking care of Princess. I wanted to do other things.
Hi, Amy.
Hi, Laurie. Hi, Tia.
You want to go to Chase's house?
I can't. I still have to take Princess for a walk today.
Are you tired of taking care of that dog? You can't do anything.
I wish I could, but I can't.
Oh, well, if you want to spend your whole life with the dog. See you tonight?
Yeah.
Sorry you can't come, Amy.
It's okay. I don't mind.
Come on, Taya.
Bye, Amy.
Minute. What time will you be home tonight?
Laurie's mother's gonna bring us home at 9 o'clock.
Have you fed Princess?
Oh no, not yet. There they are. Would you feed her for me, Dad?
Amy, I didn't promise to take care of Princess. You did. Didn't you?
Yes.
She's your responsibility. You didn't take Princess for a walk today either.
I was too busy, Mom.
I don't call going over to Tracy's being busy.
Busy or not, you made a promise to Mr. Flynn. Now go on over and take care of that dog. Your friends can wait.
After she left, my mom and dad were pretty mad at me when I told them what happened. But they didn't punish me or anything. They knew how terrible I already felt. They even helped me look for Princess, but I still couldn't find her. I guess Princess didn't think I was very dependable. How would I find her? Said that it would be a good idea to put an ad in the newspaper asking if anyone had seen Princess. I used the money that I was saving for my puppy to buy the ad. After losing Princess, my puppy wasn't so important anymore. Find Princess. I promised Mr. Flynn that I would take care of her. But even the ad didn't seem to help. The day before Mr. Flynn was coming home, Princess was still gone.
Mom?
Yes?
What should I tell Mr. Flynn?
You have to tell him the truth. That's the only thing you can tell him.
But what if he gets mad at me?
He probably will be upset with you. Let him know how hard you're looking for Princess.
I wish I could just run away.
I know it's not easy. But some things in life we just have to do. Like taking care of pets and keeping promises that we make. Now you have to tell Mr. Flynn what happened.
I know I have to, but it's so hard. Mr. Flynn loves Princess and needs her.
I know.
Amy, is that you?
Yes, Mr. Flynn.
How do you feel?
Fine, just a little stiffness in my leg. Where's Princess? I thought she'd be out here to greet me.
She ran away, Mr. Flynn. I guess I forgot to shut the gate. I came over in the morning, it was open, and Princess was gone.
When did she go away?
3 days ago. I'm sorry, Mr. Flynn. I've been looking so hard for her.
You promised you'd take care of her. I depended on you. Don't cry, Amy.
Aren't you mad at me?
No. Getting mad won't bring Princess back.
I'm sorry I broke my promise.
Listen, everyone's broken a promise at least once in their life.
Have you, Mr. Flynn?
Yes, I remember. I once promised my little sister I'd take her to the circus with me. I don't know why. Instead, I took my friend.
Did you get in trouble?
No. My father said, Thomas, I'm not going to punish you or even scold you. He says, I hope you've learned a lesson. And I did. You know what it was?
A promise is important.
Yes. And when we make a promise, we have to try our hardest to keep it.
I'm sorry I let you down, Mr. Flynn. I'll find Princess.
We'll find her together. That's all that matters now.
Is this the doll that you were looking for?
Princess!
Yes, thank you. Where did you find her?
At the hospital. She was outside the front door, watching everyone.
Oh, Princess. Let me get to the reward.
Sorry it's all on nickels and stuff. I got it out of my puppy bank.
That's okay. I'll put this in my own bank.
Thanks again for finding her.
You're welcome, and thank you.
Oh, Princess, I've been looking everywhere for you.
Amy, is that you? Princess, is that you? Princess! Princess! Oh, what a good girl. Where did you find her?
I put an ad in the newspaper and a little boy brought her over. He said that he found her near the hospital.
She must have been looking for me. What a good girl, Princess. I sure did miss you. Sit down. Yeah, that's a girl. Thank you for finding her, Amy. You put the ad in the paper yourself?
Yeah, I used the money that I was saving.
What about your puppy?
I guess I'll start over. Now I know what it really means to have a puppy.
You know, I'm going to need some help around here. Someone to help me with Princess. Would you help me take care of her?
You trust me after what happened?
Of course I do.
I'd love to, Mr. Flynn. Thank you.
Thank you.
I learned a lot of things that summer, like how important promises are and how much responsibility it takes to have a pet. They depend on us, just like Mr. Flynn depends on Princess. My puppy, I promised myself that I would be responsible and always think of him before myself. Mr. Flynn said that's what love is, an animal need love just like we do. Thank you.